we have been overdue to please God in every area of our life.
Hmm? Why?
Christ is not down on the cross so we can please the devil.
Amen.
Christ is not down on the cross so we can please ourselves.
Yes, Lord.
Christ is not on the cross to remind us that we are destined for hell. But Christ redeemed us and take our destiny forever and give us a new lease of life. We are candidates for hell, but God said not so. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever shall believe in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. He that hath the Son hath life, he that hath not the Son hath not life. If you are here today and you have turned away from our wicked ways, and we are given a life in Jesus, guess what? You have life. You will never go to hell. You can make mistakes, but you will never go to hell, no matter what you do. Because you're in the ark. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. If Christ died for us on the cross, as he did, then we have to do everything we can to please him that died. He gave his life. All he wants us to do is to live a life for him. To agree with him.
Yeah.
God has a purpose in mind when he made us. A life without a purpose is an experiment. So anything you do outside of the will of God for your life is an experiment. An experiment is something you do in the laboratory. If it doesn't work out, you throw it in the trash. It's an experiment. God said, I did not die so your life can be an experiment. I died so you can have a purpose in life. God is the God of plan, purpose, and direction. He loves you. He cares about you. You are somebody to him. You are more than conqueror. Many of us have not realized our potential. Right now, some of you drove to get here this morning. If you drove to get here this morning and your car is parked in the garage or in the parking lot, you can look at the car while you're standing there. You never know if you go on the highway to start the key at the ignition. So many of you have been looking at yourself in a stagnant situation. You need to look through the eyes of God to see your potential.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
God said, you are more than a conqueror. Yeah. You can do all things through Christ. That's strength. Don't you quit on him, don't you give up on him.
Hallelujah.
Christ is not down on the cross so you can give up on him.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Living to please God. I will tell you something that is very interesting. If you are here today and you're always discouraged and you're always worried about how things are going to get done, you are not pleasing God. He said, my peace I give you, my peace I give us, live unto you, my peace I live with you. In the world you shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer, I have overcome the world.
Yeah.
Christ has conquered the grave.
Hallelujah.
Men fear most death. And the Bible says, by the grace of God, Christ took death for all men. Nobody has to force us to walk with God. Old Testament says that the Lord is good. It's an ignorance. It's a lack of renewed mind. It's a lack of purpose. It's a lack of vision. The Bible was working with the devil when Christ died for us. The devil is a bad devil, and God is a very good God.
Hallelujah.
God said, I want to live you gently by my spirit. The devil said, I want to drive you to drink. So what do you want to do to somebody that will drive you to drink, but you will be led by the spirit? He said, with loving kindness, I will love you.
Yeah.
With loving kindness.
Yeah.
With loving kindness.
Yeah.
For God so loved the world, that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever shall believe in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Many of us have not had a chance to understand that everything that God tells us to do is for our own benefit.
Yeah.
If you live to please God, then you're living for your purpose. When you live to please God, you're living to serve the purpose of God, the reason why you are made. A car is meant to be driven. I don't care how cute you look. You might have the best car in the world, you cannot put it on the highway to drive it. You got a problem. We need to serve the purpose of God in our generation. We need to put our hope in God. We need to say, Lord, I'm tired of being driven to drink by the enemy. I want to walk for you, Lord.
Yes.
Pierce my head.
Yeah.
Pierce my head. Let me be a slave forever. Living to please God. So many people do not understand that when the Bible says living to please God, it's not so he can get everything from you. He's trying to give something to you.
Yeah.
He's trying to give you a liberty. Whatever the Spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty and freedom.
Thank you.
If you're not walking with God, but I believe to know you're in bondage.
Yeah.
It comes with the warranty.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you. Who else would not like the way Christ died for us? And he shed his blood. He changed our destiny forever. He forgave us of all our sins. He cleansed us from all unrighteousness. He gave us a new lease on life. He said, I love you with an everlasting love. With loving kindness have I drawn thee. I will never leave you nor forsake you. I want to lead you. I want to guide you. I want to direct you. I want to protect you. I want to help you in every area of your life. Only a person in their right mind will not follow the leading of the Spirit. Have you ever been to a place before that you don't know? And you have to depend on the GPS to get where you're going? If you tell you to turn around, like you turn around, you never be found. The GPS may be wrong now. Sometimes you say you have reached your destination, and you look, it's a grass field. God will allow it to happen that way, so you don't trust on the GPS by saying, put your hope in God. GPS can make a mistake, but God never make a mistake. He said, I want to fill you with my Holy Spirit. I want to lead you by my Holy Spirit. I want to empower you by my Holy Spirit. Filled, led, and empowered. Shall say power, after that the Holy Ghost is coming upon you. The power is not for the good people, it's a power to live right. It's a power to walk with God in the face of opposition. It's a power to be at peace with God when everything is going wrong around you. Because he said, I never leave you nor forsake you. That's my boldness, say, the Lord is my helper. Hallelujah.
Yeah, thank you.
Living to please God. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Christ is not down on the cross, so we can please ourselves. He's down on the cross, so we can please him that died for us.
Yeah.
And Christ does not want us to experiment with our life. A life without a purpose is an experiment. And you can only find your purpose in Christ. And then we live, and then we move, and then we have our being.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Thank
he loves you. He cares about you. We need to come to a point of trust, a total trust in God. Sometimes we think we know better than God. We don't say it, we just go against what God says for our life. And if it doesn't work out, then we'll come back and say, well, Lord, it didn't work. I knew there before. The sign will not be there. It's a street not true. If it's a street not true, you can drive. You could have driven maybe 100 or 200 yards. You feel like you go somewhere and the head there is nowhere to go. He told you before you get that the street is not true. So what you want to go through is a whole lot of street not true. You try to get home. When you don't go with the Holy Spirit, you go through a street not true. But it looks like it's going somewhere when you begin. All of a sudden you're able to end and then you get frustrated and then you have to come back now. You wait, you got going to the end and you come back from the end. If you keep on doing that, you will be out of that, you need to walk, eventually. So when are you going to wipe up and say, Lord, I don't want to go through any more street, not true.
Yeah.
See, you missed the cycle to talk to go in the right direction.
Right.
Because I don't want to go through a street, not true. I don't want to go through a one-way street. When you say one-way, don't go in the opposite direction of a one-way. If you say one-way, and you go in the opposite direction of a one-way, you're going to be dead and wrong.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Jesus. Living to please God. People will do you wrong. It's left for you and me to forgive. Hallelujah.
Yes, thank you.
People, it's left for you and me to let go of all offenses.
Yeah, thank
hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Many of us have forgiven. We have forgotten that God will forgive us of everything.
Yes.
So just waiting for somebody to do you wrong. Wait a minute. Nobody do me wrong yet.
Help us.
Somebody to do me wrong so I can work in unforgiveness. And bitterness, and envy, and jealousy, and anger, and rage, and everything that goes along with it. That's the work of the devil.
Yes, sir.
You are an instrument in the hand of God.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
A person would have been better out to reject God and be used by the devil than to accept God, worship the God, and then to place himself in the hand of the devil. The redeemer of the Lord as an instrument in the hand of the devil. That's what God made.
Yes,
God said, I don't like that. I pray for you in my own blood.
Yes,
don't you do that to me. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, thank you.
In order for us to please God, we have to follow His will. Many of us say we want to please God, but we never read the Bible like we're supposed to. And if you read that, it's not what we want because it's not going our way, then we just kind of put it down and go the way we feel like we ought to go. They say, what does it matter right to man, but the end of it is the way of death.
Yes,
hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God says, I care about you. You are somebody to me. Many of us have a limited prayer life.
Yes,
what I mean by that is this. When we look at a situation and look like it's impossible, then we just quit. We need to understand when we look the most impossible. That's when we need to press in. Yes. Because what's impossible with man is possible with God.
Thank you, Lord.
You can do all things through Christ that changes you. It's not a cliche, it's a reality. Because
yes,
when you involve God in any area, then all things are possible. Which is why you don't get discouraged when you are faced with an impossible situation and say, well, what do you use myself for? Says who? Have you been to God lately? You have an access to the throne of grace. For we have not a high priest that cannot be touched with the feelings of our infirmities. He was at all points tempted as we are, but yet without sin. Let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace that we find the grace to help us. Now come boldly.
Hallelujah.
It's not depending on you and me, it's depending on God. Hallelujah. All power belongs to Him.
Yeah.
Stop whining. Get up that thing and start praying like you're supposed to pray. Pray with the backbone. Pray like you're supposed to answer your prayers. Hallelujah. I never leave enough for thank you. I give a bold say, Lord, our helper.
Yeah.
Oh, if you don't know what I'm going through, say it's true.
Yeah.
If you are walking in the valley of the shadow of death,
I'm
fearing for that other thing.
Yes,
see, a shadow of a knife cannot cut you. A shadow of a bullet cannot kill you. A shadow of a death cannot kill you. It's a shadow, not the reality.
Because
I never leave you, not forsake you. Boldly say, the Lord is my helper.
Hallelujah.
We give up too soon. We quit too easily. Because we forget that God is all powerful. That God is all knowing. Living to please God. God will not be pleased if you quit in every time you turn around. How will you have a demonstration of the power of the Holy Spirit when you always quit? Quitters never win and winners never quit.
Yeah.
You gotta have a backbone to trust God.
Yeah, thank you, Lord.
I don't care if you look at you just want you only. You only with God can take on the whole world. If God before us, who can be against us?
Yeah.
He did not spare his only begotten Son, but that will deliver up for us all. How shall he not freely to give us all things? We quit too soon. Because it looks like it's impossible. But the Bible says what's impossible with man is possible with God. If you have a faith of that faith, mustard grain seed, you shall say to the mountain to be moved. Mountain is the problem that is overwhelming to you.
Yeah.
Bible says tell him to move because God me now with you.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Tell the mountain to move because God goes now.
That's right.
It's not the time to quit, not the time to get discouraged. You get discouraged when you trust it in your own power. When you are faced with overwhelming situation and you try to quit, that's because you're trusting in your own power. You forget the God factor.
Yeah.
Don't you ever quit. Don't you ever give up.
Yeah.
It's not by power. It's not by Obama's spirit.
Yeah,
hallelujah. Living to please God.
Yeah.
Oh, glory be to God today. Glory be to God today.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah,
thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Psalm 147, verse 10. He said, his pleasure is not in the strength of a horse, nor the delight in the legs of a warrior. The Lord delights in those who fear him and put their hope in his unfailing love. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, glory be to God today. Hallelujah today. God is a very wonderful God. He alone is worthy. Worthy to be praised. Thank you, Jesus. I'm 147 verse 10. That's what I just read. 147. Don't forget the one in front of me. Amen. 150 minus 3.
Amen.
His pleasure is not in the strength of a horse. His delight in the leg of a warrior. His pleasure is not in the strength of a horse. His pleasure is not in what you can do in your own ability. Hallelujah. Never depend on your own ability when God is dealing with you. Because our ability is limited. But God's ability is unlimited, unhindered. It's all powerful. It's all knowing. He knows all things. He can do all things. Never count yourself out when it looks like it's overwhelming.
Yeah.
If God before us, who can be against us? If that did not spare his only begotten Son, but have him deliver for us all, how shall it not freely to him give us all things? Thank you, Holy Spirit. So Psalm 147 verse 10, right? His pleasure is not in the strength of the horse. So it's not by your own ability. That's what that is meaning. No, it's delight in the leg of a warrior. The Lord delight in those who fear him, those who put their hope in his unfailing love. Those who put their hope in what? In his unfailing love. So where is your hope today? God said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. I will never fail you. God is all powerful. Where is your hope today? Have you called on God lately, expecting that God will answer you? Or you come from the point of discouragement. Are you calling not trusting? Because it's so overwhelming, whatever you think you're going through. I need to bring it to remind you that we make some things that are possible, but not with God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Hey, thank you.
If I want to live to please God, then I have to find out what his will is. You cannot please a person when you don't know what they like. God is holy. Yes. If you want to please, you have to be holy. Without holiness, no man shall see God.
Amen.
It's possible to go to church, go home, and never see God. Because if God will show up in an unholy situation, the person will die. Hallelujah. So with holiness, thank you, Jesus. Without holiness, no man shall see God. God is holy. Don't quit on God. Don't give up on God. Living to please God. Living to please God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. If I'm living to please God, I have to find out how God thinks. I have to find out what God likes. See, a lot of husband and wife never please each other. God never found out what each other like. I'm not going to give my wife what I like. I have to give her what she likes. You understand?
Yeah.
If I want to please my wife, I have to give her what she likes. Do you want to confess for you? My wife likes Chinese food. I think I told you this before. And I thought, well, maybe Chinese food is greasy. I go and get a boiled rice. See, a boiled rice is not fried rice. So you took one spoon of here, but two spoons. Wait a minute. This is loud. You don't think of Chinese food. That's what I got a confession to make. I gave you what I think you ought to like. So I will be giving God what you think you ought to like.
Hallelujah.
God to like a little fornication and adultery as long as I lift my hands. You have to like me going in my own council, go doing my own thing. I'm praising God. At least I praise God. Yeah, living at peace, rest of all men. You belong to God. It's the glory and the lift of our head. It's the author and the finisher of our faith. Make up your mind. Choose to this day whom you will serve. Whether the God of the Amorite or the God of your forefathers served in the other side of the Jordan. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Make up your mind and go with God all the way.
Yeah.
It's a dangerous thing to be on the fence. You miss the blessing and everything that goes along with it. Because you have not made up your mind.
Yeah.
And the faith in your mind. Unable to decide whether to go with God or not to go with God. But say, I don't want you on the fence. Nobody in church will be able to say I look warm.
Yes, sir.
They don't want to be cold, they don't want to be hot, they just want to be in the middle. I want to spill out of my mouth.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Hey, thank you.
He alone is worthy.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Thank you, Father.
So we have many, many options. But you see, just because I have an option doesn't mean you have to do the option. If the option doesn't land on what the Bible says, I want to please God, then you leave the option alone.
Yes, sir.
Abortion is illegal, but it's ungodly.
Amen. Amen.
Fornication and adultery is okay with the culture, but it's ungodly.
Amen.
If you want to please God, you have to understand that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Whichever window or door you left open before you gave your life to Jesus, they were going to come and knock on that door again to see if you meant what to say. Somebody I've not talked to in 10 years, the phone will ring. You don't know where you found your number. Is you still saved? Not are you still saved? Is you still saved? I ain't going to do nothing. I just want to see you. The last time you saw them 10 years ago, what happened? What was it? Sexual immorality and everything else.
Mm-hmm.
So you said no, but I come to see them. No feeling about what's going to happen.
Mm-hmm.
And then you kind of look like nobody did.
Mm-hmm.
The spirit is willing and the flesh is weak. Yeah. Leave it to please God.
Hallelujah.
God is in every place. The eyes of the Lord is in every place, beyond the evil and the good.
Hey,
make up your mind. Go with God when nobody is looking.
Yes.
If you go with God when nobody is looking, it's called integrity.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 14. Thank you, Jesus. Let's find out what we are made. Amen. We are made to bring up pleasure.
Yeah.
We are made to please Him.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
He is doing his work.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Let's start from verse 8. Each of the four living creatures, this is Revelation chapter 4. Revelation 4, 8. Each of the four living creatures had six wings and was covered with eyes all around, even under its wings. Day and night they never stop saying, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, which was and is to come. Day and night they never stop saying, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, which was and is to come. They never stop saying it, day and night. Never stop saying day and night. Verse 9. Whenever the living creatures give glory, honor, and thanks to him who sits on the throne, what do we need to give to God? Glory, honor, and thanks. What do we need to give to God? Glory, honor, and thanks. So our lives need to give him glory by the way we live our life. That's how I get the glory. Don't just say, oh, glory to God. How do we live? You cannot say glory to God and live like a devil.
Yes, sir.
Your body belongs to God. Your soul belongs to God. Your mind belongs to God. Your spirit, every part of us belongs to God. We are purchased in full.
Yes.
If you buy a new car, you better believe it's going to include four tires.
Yes.
Even I do sometimes, unless you buy a tricycle or something. Whenever the four living creatures, this is verse 9, Revelation chapter 4, verse 9. Revelation 4, 9. Whenever the living creatures give glory, honor, and thanks to him who sits on the throne and who lives forever and ever, the 20 and the 24 elders fall down before him who sits on the throne and worship him. The 24 elders fall down before him who sits on the throne and worship him. Worship is a way of life. It's not just something you say out of your mouth. Our life needs to bring God a worship.
Yes.
A worship means you create an atmosphere.
Mm.
That is come. This is I'm very comfortable for God to move on your behalf.
Yes.
A worship is not just something you say out of your mouth, it's a lifestyle. A worship is going from the outer court to the inner, to the holy of the holies. See, a worship, hallelujah, will bring in direct contact with the presence of God.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. Jesus. Direct, I'm talking about a direct hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Glory.
Verse 10, 20 and the four elders, 24 elders fall down before him who sit on the throne and worship him forever and ever. They lay their crowns down before the throne and say, you are worthy, O Lord, to receive the glory and the honor and the power. For you created all things, and by your will or for your pleasure, they are created and have their being. By your will or for your pleasure. So God said, I created all things. I created all things to give me pleasure. See, there are sometimes things that you like to do that bring you pleasure. So you create the atmosphere for that to give you pleasure. Something like a piano or something. But if you have that piano, if it's in tune, it will give you pleasure. If it's in tune and you can play, it will give you pleasure. If it's in tune and you cannot play, you have a noise. If you can play and it's not in tune, it still won't give you pleasure. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
God said the way you live your life, I want it to be pleasing to me.
Yes.
I love you, I care about you. I got a plan for your life. I got a purpose. The thought of God towards you is of peace and not of evil.
Yes.
To give you an expected end, and I will be fond of you. I will never live in the forsaken that way. But you say, lost my helper. We need to be tired of bumping our head.
Yes.
You have too many enough action in your forehead and you never stop.
Yes.
It will heal, you go back again. Pow! Stop! Go with God!
Hallelujah.
I thought you were going to walk up there. It was the same right to man, but the kind of this is the way of death. Stop bumping your head and start walking with God for real.
Yes.
If you walk with God, you get to your destination.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
God is not a man that you should love. God is not a man that you should repent. Sometimes our affection for the forbidden is so strong that when God says no, we just go ahead anyway. Sometimes our affection for the forbidden is so strong that when God said no, just go ahead anyway. Like he didn't say no. And then you bump in and come back. Well, Lord, I didn't know. Yes, you do.
Yeah.
What do you mean you didn't know? Yes, you do.
Yeah.
He said, stop, you won't.
Yeah.
And they try to blame God when it don't work out.
Wow.
It's a road that leads to no way. You go for a little bit. But if you get to the end and find it leads to no way, after you travel for 10 miles, you might be run out of gas in the road that leads to nowhere.
Wow.
That's what brings frustration.
Yeah.
I thought it was going to work. It looked like everything was okay. They said, well, that semen right to man, but the end of it is well. They said, because the semen right does not mean you should not seek God. Seek God knows the future. Yeah. God declared the past, present, and the future.
Yes.
Listen to me. The past, the present, and the future are in front of God at the same time.
Yeah.
You have experience of the past. You have an idea of the present, but you don't know the future.
Yeah.
God said, when I help you, when I talk to you, I have the past, present, and future in front of me at the same time.
Yeah.
There's no future in God. You know that? Because it's ever been. It's not trying to figure out something in the future. Your future is in the presence of God in the now. My future is in the presence of God in the now. Say
my future
is in the presence of God
in the now.
So why don't we listen? Why don't we agree with God? Why do we act like we're going to miss something if you obey God? Yes, we'll miss something, all right? A headache, a broken heart.
Amen.
Yes. We are creating all things. And for the pleasure, the world are created. For your pleasure. Some people want to see flag yesterday. They went on the right. Why do we ride on the right? For your pleasure. Cool breeze, cool make them flip and everything. You get the cool breeze and everything. If you don't get it, then you won't be doing it. God said, I made it. She give me pleasure. What give me pleasure? Authentic worship. Loving God willingly. He could have made us like a robot. I love you, I love you, I love you. He said, I'm going to give you an option. I want you to love me willingly.
Yeah,
I want you to think of reminiscence of what I've done for you.
Yeah.
I gave my life on the cross of Calvary because I love you so much. I think you won't die for. The angels that they did wrong, that is it. No redemption. What is man that you are mindful of him? As the son of man that you care for. Hallelujah. Angels did something wrong, no redemption. Devil did something wrong, no redemption. With something wrong, Christ came after us.
Hallelujah.
You are made in his image and his
likeness. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you.
Glory be to God.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you.
Thank you. There's a man named Ezra in the Bible. Ezra is described. He was the one that was reading the book of the law to all the people. And he was supposed to lead the rest of the people back to Jerusalem from exile. You know what he said? He said, I was ashamed to ask the king to send some soldiers to go with us back to Jerusalem. Because I already told the king that God is all powerful, that if you do his will, he will protect you. How can I go back to the king now? I said, can you give us some armed military people so the nation will get there safely? When the king is looking. So I don't know how much you know about your God.
Hallelujah. Thank you.
Did you hear what I said? Ezra said,
hallelujah.
I was ashamed to go to the king to ask him for help or go back to Jerusalem. Because I already told the king, I said, hey king, if you do God's will, he'll protect you, he'll keep you, he'll love you, he'll care about you. How can I go back to the king now? I said, well, can you give us some help, please?
Right.
We're so scared to go back to Jerusalem. We don't want him to steal whatever is left. We take him back. He said, no, I won't do that. And they prayed, and they fasted, and God watched over them.
Yeah. Yeah.
Then I know they are God's mighty escrow. Do you know your God today?
Hallelujah.
Do you know your God? Do you believe in that God? Do you know that it's all powerful? Then trust it with all your heart. Trust the Lord with all your heart. Do that with all understanding. All your words and knowledge. And this child direct your path.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. Ezra chapter 8. That's where I'm going. Ezra. Thank you, Jesus. We need to know this. Thank you, Jesus. Glory be to God in the highest. On that place of the open. Between 2 Chronicles and Nehemiah, that's why you have Ezra.
Hey,
thank you, Jesus. Chapter 8. Thank you, Jesus.
Hey.
He alone is worthy. Worthy to be praised. Thank you, Jesus. Ezra chapter 8, verse 21. There, by the heaven canal, I proclaim a fast so that we humble ourselves before our God and ask him for a safe journey for us and our children with all our possessions. See, there in the harbor canal, I proclaim the fast so that we might humble ourselves before our God and ask Him for a safe journey for us and our children with all our possessions. I was ashamed to ask the king for soldiers and horsemen to protect us from the enemy on the road, because we are told the king, the gracious hand of our God is on everyone who looks to Him. The gracious hand of our God is on who? Everyone. Are you looking to Him today? Then the gracious hand is upon you. You don't have to be afraid of gang banging or shooting or on-site shooting. God will protect you. I never leave you nor forsake you. Boldness and lost my helper. Hallelujah. You are anointed. Talk to my anointed, my prophet, no harm. You belong to God.
Hallelujah.
I say, if you make it today, you never leave it or forsake you. That you boldness and lost our helper. Some of you are in the fight of quitting, just feel like giving up, because whatever you go through is overwhelming.
Yeah.
What was the last time you checked with God and called on God?
Yeah,
in true faith. Open the door, putting your hope in Him.
Hey, thank you.
I was ashamed. I can't go back to ask the king. I already told the king, if somebody will do God's will, I walk with him, oh, he protect you. Such a mighty God. If it's a mighty God, then why are you not trusting Him to help you right now?
Yeah.
Why is it like Putin when you say you have a mighty God? After I said, I said, what a mighty God we serve. And then, oh, I don't know how to get the house, no, to get food.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
It's a very mighty God, just can't give you your food, right? Or pay your house, no. That's the way we live. Terrible. Change your mindset. Renew your mind. What will God for you? Put your hope in Him. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it, and they are saved. I never leave you nor forsake you. That you may boldly say, the Lord is my helper. Yet though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for thou art with me. Your rod and your staff to comfort me. It's the glory and the lifter of my head. It's the honor and the presence of my face. When my heart is overwhelmed, living for the rock that is under night. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. Through the Father, you shall not be born.
Hallelujah.
If you know that the gracious hand of God is on you. So what's next to do? Pray, seek Him. Look at the next verse, and then we fasted. And they told us, not our plate, because we're really trusting in God to bring us through for real. What was the last time you turned your plate? Told you to fast 5 years ago, you stayed and fasted. Go after the pig's noodle and the French fries. The greatest hand of God is on everyone who goes to Him, but the second is against all who forsake Him. So we fasted and petitioned at God about this, and He answered our prayer. You fasted and petitioned at God. So whatever you go through today, fast and petition. Talk to God. It's a heavenly Father. It's a Father good pleasure to give you the kingdom. He loves you. He never leave you nor forsake you. That's me. Boldly say, the Lord is my helper. Hallelujah. If you are walking the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil. The shadow of death cannot kill you. The shadow of a knife cannot cut you. The shadow of a bullet cannot kill you. It belongs to, it's a shadow, not a reality. God can protect you. Hey, stand up before at your side, stand up at the right hand, but shall not come nigh thee. For shall give his angels charge over thee. Hallelujah. Jesus said, I don't care if you live in the worst place in St. Louis, wherever you live, that's where the hand of God is. He protects you. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. How dare you pray? God will watch over you. How dare you see God's face? How dare you have a backbone and wait on the Lord? See, sometimes we have, you know what the problem we have sometimes? We are too much in a hurry. The Bible says, I could have fainted unless I believe to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait on the Lord and be of good courage as it shall strengthen your heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. Wait, I say, wait on the timing. If you're not going to wait on God, why are you praying? We're not praying to pacify God, we're praying to get some answers. And if you pray and wait, and then God speak to you. It is through faith and patience that you hear the promises. You need to be tired of God going in the wrong direction and praying. God is making you turn, no, I'm ready for you to turn, but I just thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
God has been blessing you up. God's leaving you alone. No, I just thank you, Lord, keep on going.
Yes, Lord.
I lied to you for 10 years. What do you think changed when God says to me, no? Nothing?
No.
I want to go in the donkey ride one more time. Every time they see you where, you know I love you, you know what's coming. They say, yes, can I just get a couple of dollars from you? You're supposed to be my girl, man. I know you're supposed to be my girl. You're doing good, man. I'm telling you. Take you out to a movie, spend $10 on you, I get $400 from you. We're doing good. They always show up when they have a need. And they know what to do. Take you out to the movie, get some popcorn and some soda. You will never be a good businessman if you always lose money.
Right.
Well, go with God.
Yeah.
Think. Put on your thinking cap.
Yeah.
I don't have time to show someone they always need money. They never go, oh, I need money. No, no, no. Hey, babe, let's go. Let's go and sit down. To go to White Castle. Yeah, give me. He took me out. I mean, he took me out, right? You're about to lose your rent money. Keep your money in your pocket. See if they come back. They say, I need money. Oh, yes, I know you do. But you gotta walk. You gotta walk. Give it to me. I'm going to give it to you. When the last 10, then they got the money for the hanging. Nothing came back. Even the bank will not lose somebody money that will not give it back. They didn't do it 10 times, it's falling for it. Oh, it looks like it's, I mean, it looks like it's crazy, true. I asked, this looks so beautiful, left there, yes, 10. God will make sure you don't get the next money. Because if you do, you're going to give it to a person that hates God.
Yeah.
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 It's a person that they have. You're codependent.
Wow. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
I don't know why I'm going this route.
Hallelujah.
I'm going to the Holy Ghost.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Listen to please God. You have a discernment of spirit.
Yes.
Find out who your friend is through prayer. Yes. God will reveal to you everything about every person.
Yes, he will.
I'm telling you, man. One time I met this young lady before I got married. She was beautiful. Nice person. And somebody told me, well, I said, God told me to tell you that's your wife. God told you to tell me that's my wife. I better check with God myself.
Right.
So sometimes we treat that like a stepchildren. Yeah. God told me to tell you. Oh, yes. I know that's my wife because they told me to tell you.
Wow.
What happened to you? You don't have a personal relationship with God. Don't you understand that anybody can be wrong?
Yes.
But if you seek God yourself, you are not stepchildren.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
You have an access to the throne of grace.
Yes.
As you have an access to the throne of grace,
yes.
Seek God by yourself. Let God lead you and guide you and direct you and empower you.
Wow. Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
I pray about God's name.
Thank you.
Not anyone. Mm-hmm. When I was praying, God showed me something that's very interesting. Inside of her heart, God showed me something this lady's heart. You have two men there. It was me and the Caucasian looking guy in the same heart. When I was praying, I got up. I said, sister, I got to tell you something. I said, what's that? I said, we got a problem. You told me you love me. You told me God said you're going to be my wife, but you have two of you. Two of us inside your own heart.
Yeah.
So I said, so this Caucasian guy are not with me in your heart. Like, oh my goodness, how did you figure out? How did you know that? I did it. I sought the Lord. God revealed the tenderness of our heart.
True.
See, many of you are so engrossed in lust that you forget to pray.
Yeah. Amen. All right.
Can you tell me anything? This is okay.
Reach it.
God revealed two people in one heart.
Yeah.
All right.
It is great. What I was describing was in her heart because I've been with God. And she was shocked. She was getting away from me. But, oh, man, I'm scared of you now. How did you know that? I didn't.
No.
Many of us don't want to hear from God clearly.
No.
God will show you that sometimes you want to go. Well, if I wait now, it might be a long time before someday, sure, then just go like that. Because you're adamant in going the wrong direction. Because I don't want to be a knucklehead in wrong direction. I reveal this to you. See, many of us are praying, but we are not sincere with God. Because if it shows, it's there for you. If you don't go with what we think we ought to do, then we just kind of let God go and go in the wrong direction. And then bump your head and bump your finger off and come back. Sometimes we don't even come back. We don't go back in the world. After warning from God. For whoever would love life and see many good days, let him keep his tongue from evil. Keep his tongue from evil. Keep his tongue from evil. Stop speaking evil of people and things. If you do, you are not working with God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Right. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I know why you're speaking and be comfortable.
Mm.
It's truly the end of the enemy.
Wow.
If you're speaking evil and you're comfortable, then you're truly the end of the enemy.
Wow.
1 Peter chapter 3, let's take a look at it. First Peter. Not put that in the back. Verse 8. Finally, all of you, this is First Peter chapter 3, verse 8. Finally, all of you, be like-minded, sympathetic, love one another, and be compassionate and humble. Love one another, be compassionate, have a compassion. Don't tell me you're working with God and you're hateful. Don't do that. They don't go together. God is love. God is love. Be compassionate, be kind, be compassionate. God is love.
Yeah.
And humble.
Yeah.
Humble.
Yeah.
Humble.
Yeah.
Pride is the thing that. Pride is. Pride, I don't just a little bit more than God. You don't say it, but you act like it. God said, make it left, say, I gotta go straight this time.
Hallelujah. Thank you.
Do not repay evil with evil or insult with insult. See, a lot of people have a revenge mind.
Yes, sir.
A revenge mind. Vengeance is my said the Lord. But you always have the revenge.
Yes.
Always have to avenge yourself. Always have to do something to somebody. Always. Don't you ever do this.
Amen.
If you do that, you're not pleasing to God. Living to please God, God's avenger is mine. Living alone, forgive and forget and keep on going. Amen. Do not repay evil with evil. This is verse 9. Or insult with insult. On the contrary, repay evil with blessing. Because of this you are called, so that you may inherit a blessing. For whoever will love life and see good days must keep your tongue from evil. The tongue is full of evil, deadly poison. It's a relentless evil. You can damage somebody created by God with your tongue. You can damage somebody, you can destroy somebody's life. Send the wrong thing about them and destroy them. Whoever will love life and see good days, keep them from evil, and they are delivered from deceitful speech. Deceitful speech. They must turn from evil and do good. You want to please God, turn from evil and do good.
Yes.
God said, I do it for my pleasure.
Hey, thank you.
And God's pleasure is not evil.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Jesus. You must seek peace and pursue it.
Hallelujah.
Some people, man, they don't seek no peace. They always stand up in the pot. They always stand up in the pot. You know what she's saying about you? You know what he said, she said about you? You know what she said, he said, she said about you? Stand up in the pot. Praise the Lord. You know what he said, she said about you? Wherever they are, there's a confusion and a complete mess. Because the tongue is used for evil.
Wow.
Pointless.
Wow. Hallelujah.
For the eyes of the Lord are the righteous, and the saints are attended to their prayer. For the eyes of the Lord are the righteous. If you do this according to the will of God, God says, I got my eyes on you. And when you pray, I'm attentive to you.
Amen.
Why don't you want to take my words in your lips, know that you won't do my will? You want to do your own thing, and then pray to God. What a complete mess. Don't you understand that the prayer, you don't even go behind your nose. When you do your own thing, I just go pray a prayer to God. The Lord has the instruction show that he cannot see. Not that he says to that he cannot. Yeah. But our sins and iniquities have kept him from hearing from what?
Yeah.
Do your own thing and they try to get God, like God doesn't know anything. Wow. You act like they don't know.
Yeah.
Leave your sister alone, leave your brother alone, stop talking bad about people.
Yeah.
Stop.
Yeah.
See, yeah. You've learned to bad mouth, you're an expert in bad mouthing people.
Wow.
Come to see you. Then the image and likeness of God, leave me alone. They may not be bound, but God is working on them.
Yes. Yes.
Don't take the job of the Holy Ghost.
Yes. Yes.
I said, don't take the job of the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. Always pointing fingers, always looking for something that's wrong with somebody. Leave me alone.
Amen.
My own business.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Pastor, they must turn from evil and do good.
Yeah.
Come from evil, what? Do good. They must seek peace and pursue seek peace. What was the last time you seek peace?
What?
Always causing a discord. Always causing something, always causing a confusion.
Wow.
Something when you see them get real quickly. Shame them. We are about to have some confusion. Because good. Like Nebo. Husband of Abigail said he's a fool, full of goes everywhere he goes. For the eyes of the Lord are the righteous. For the eyes of the Lord are the righteous. If you are in good standing with God, if you do what the Bible says, pray. I'm already looking at you, my eyes is on you already. Fire up the prayer so I can get it. Fire up the prayer so I can get it. Eyes of the Lord are the righteous. And his ears are attentive.
Hallelujah.
To their prayer. But the faith of the Lord is against those who do evil. So you do evil and you try to pray. God says, I'm against you. Who are you trying to pray to? When you do everybody wrong, who are you trying to pray with? When you lie, but then who are you trying to pray to when you're causing a discord? And at 1 year you won't even change. And you're trying to pray to me. Talk to yourself, please. You're not talking to me.
Yeah.
See if you get an answer from talking to yourself.
Hallelujah.
But the first of all is against those who do evil.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Who's going to harm you if you're eager to do good? But even if you suffer for what is right, you are blessed. Do not fear their threat. Do not be frightened. Verse 15. But in your heart, revere or set aside Christ as Lord. Always be willing to prepare to give an answer to everyone who asks to give the reason for the hope that you have. Every time somebody comes into your life, you see a reason for the hope that you have in God. It's not a complete mess. And unforgiveness and jealousy and anger. Friend of mine. You don't see a living for all the same. Venom.
Sir. Wow. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Father.
Give me a good conscience that those who speak maliciously against your good behavior in Christ will be ashamed of their slander. When you walk in with God and somebody's talking bad about you, they're going to be ashamed of their slander. Why? Because God will sit on you to protect you.
Amen.
He keep you, watch over you, he answer your prayer.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I'm not going to stop talking until I'm finished.
In glory.
If you have come to me at the last day, you don't say, I'm talking until I'm finished.
Yes, sir.
Change your ways. Let God be God for a change.
Hey.
Come under the hands of godly people. Backbiting
and
striding and striding and striding and conniving and just be choosing the end of the devil.
Yeah.
After that's why I said to wash the blood of the Lamb, not to ever do that.
Thank you, Lord.
That's a disgrace.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. Keep it up for people. Whoever was up there, I see many good days. Keep it up from evil.
Yes.
Evil from evil. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Psalm 1. Book of Psalms. Psalm 1.
Hey, hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
God is so awesome.
Yes, he is.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Book of Psalms, Psalm 1.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
That is one that does not walk in step with the wicked. No, you know what to walk in step with the wicked? Agree with them. Go in the same direction with the wicked. So who are your friends? Who are you hanging around when you're out of church?
Yes.
Who are your friends?
Hmm.
The definition of a wicked people that do to that is contrary to what the Bible says.
Yes.
God haters. That's wicked.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes. Sir. Thank you, Lord.
Yes,
Bible says you bless who don't hang walk in the step with them.
Yeah.
Or stand in the way of sinners.
Yeah.
Or take a seat in the company of mockers. You know what a mocker is? Somebody that make you feel bad about walking with God. You go to church again,
how can
you ever go to church?
Right.
That's a mocker.
Right.
You have a destiny with
yeah.
hell.
Yes,
I said, they have a destiny with hell.
Yes,
you go to church again, how can you ever go to church?
Yes.
You better leave me alone. Bible says, forsake not the assembly of the saints.
Yes, thank you.
I go to church to learn more about God, to grow in grace and knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. I don't go to church because the Bible says, I give you pastors according to my heart. And it's like, feed you with knowledge and understanding.
Yeah.
Not every pastor are going to God's heart that way. Because
yes,
you don't know.
Yes,
if you are going to God's heart, you have a care for people. You have a genuine love for people.
Hey, yes. Glory. Thank you, yes, sir. Thank you, Jesus.
Genuine love
yes.
for God's people.
Because
you'll be with them forever.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to take it ever lightly that you're in my life. You may not like what I tell you.
Hallelujah.
You don't have to like it.
Amen.
If you don't like what you're hearing, I forgive you.
Yes.
We does not walk in the step of the wicked or stand in the way of the sinners or take a seat in the company of mockers. People that mock God, you see with them at work. I just laugh together. I know those people said they are Christian. You better look before that is
right.
Some people have died because they're in the wrong direction. And it's the wrong people. God wants to separate from me.
Yeah.
Separate yourself from them before I destroy them.
Yeah.
If you don't, you go down and laugh with them. Now to be a different between the sinner and the saved person.
Yes, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Stand in the way of sinners, or take a seat in the company of mockers.
Mm-hmm.
Who are your friends?
Yeah.
Are you hiding your Christianity from your friends because you don't want them to mock you?
Mm-hmm.
So you love your friend more than God.
Wow. Hallelujah.
Those are mockers.
Hallelujah.
And you go to church again. How did that just go in and listen to somebody talk? That's what you don't understand that it's the word of life. It's not just talking. It's not an empty word.
Yeah.
Can't even do that true, that word is true.
Yeah.
The word that speaks to their spirit and their life.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hey, thank you. What's the sign of sickness? When you have a loss of appetite. If I'm preaching to you and you don't have an appetite for it, you are sick.
My God.
Maybe you don't take no meat when they are sick?
No.
No.
Yeah.
My God.
If what I'm telling you is poking you, I know come and join there. You don't like it at all. Ooh, you didn't get it.
You sick.
You got it, bro. That's why you hear sacrifice of the appointment to me with the man.
Hallelujah.
I say God is man, the man. Let the Bible someone can walk the step with the wicked or stand in the way of the sinners, take a seat with the company of mockers, take a seat with the company. So do not have a Christianity from anybody. If you don't have a Christianity from somebody, then you have another mocker.
That's right.
It's going to make joke of your walk with God if you don't know.
Yeah.
Yeah. Of course, some people would rather go to hell than have friends. But they have a good friend. How much time do you have left in the car? You go, oh, maybe a day or two. Or you just going to risk eternity for 2 weeks of friendship. Don't stand in the way of sinners. Don't stand in the way of sinners. To stand in the way of me to agree with them. The sinner was covering them up and agree with them.
Absolutely.
But if the life or walking is in the company of mockers, see, ministry love comes in the company of mockers.
Yeah.
They are people that are sent to derail your walk with God.
Yeah.
You know, I talk about God, you read the Bible again, that's the old book.
Yeah.
Says who?
Yeah.
My life depends on it.
Right.
Yeah. Right. Yes. Sir. Yes. Sir. Hallelujah. But who's the largest love of the Lord? If you're not going to walk with the company of mockers, and you're not excited about God, so where is your alliance?
Yes.
Yeah.
You're not working with mockers, and you're not working with God, so where are you? Where are thou, Adam? Where are thou? Where are thou? You ain't walking with God, you ain't walking with devil, you just ain't walking. Where are thou? But if the light is the law of the Lord, and meditate on it day and night, is the light. God said, I want you to take side. I don't want to be not a mocker and not a God lover, just in between, right in the fence. But it's the light.
Yeah.
He said, your place is the light. You know what the light is? Being kind to your wife, being kind to your husband, being really loving towards your family, that's a delight.
Yeah.
Working with God, even since we look tough, that's a delight.
Yeah.
Love is love. Delight is what the Bible says.
Yeah.
And it needs to meditate day and night. That was like a tree planted by streams of water, which is its fruit in season, whose leaf is not wither, and whatever it does, prosper. Whatever it does, prosper. Who are your friends? Are you ashamed of being a Christian when you have anger on certain people? Those are the people you need to let go of them.
Yeah.
It's not worth loving them and hating God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Not to the wicked. They are ashamed that the wind blows away. Therefore, the wicked will not stand in judgment of sinners in the assembly of the righteous. But the Lord watches over the way of the righteous. For the Lord watches over the way of the righteous because I'm watching over your way. I protect you. I'll keep you, I'll guide you, I'll lead you, I'll direct you, I'll empower you. You belong to God, you belong to me. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
God knows my doctor, do my prophet on him.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. You belong to God. God will watch over you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. All myself is scripture and I'm out of here. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Is that Proverbs 6?
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Proverbs chapter 6, verse 16. Proverbs 6:16. There are 6 things that the Lord hates. Living to please God, these are the things that God don't want to do. I just want to please God, right? Don't do this. There are 6 things that the Lord hates. Seven that are detestable to him, in haughty eyes.
Yes.
Don't be prideful. A lying
tongue.
Amen. A hand that shed innocent blood. You always bring somebody in, always lying on somebody. A hand that devises wicked schemes. Are you a schemer? A hand that devises wicked schemes. A hand that devises wicked schemes. A hand that devises wicked schemes. Wicked. Thank you, Jesus. Feel that are quick to rush into evil. A false witness who pours lies. A person who starts up conflict in the community. Just a complete mess, always disturbing the peace.
Yeah.
So it's a peace disturber. When they get here in 5 minutes, you'll have a turmoil.
Hallelujah.
When I was in the world, there's a particular guy you don't want in the party. As a person show up like this, in about 5 minutes we'll have a fight.
Wow.
Person show up, we'll take him back. Well, I see you later, maybe every night. You're going to have a problem now. You are not to be for a sin. You show up and try to take their bag. I've seen it.
Hallelujah.
I'm not going to stay for long. No, I'm not staying for long anymore. Oh, I got to see you later. I got to go. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. A hand that devises wicked schemes, feel like good to rush to do evil. A false witness who pours out lies. A false witness and a person who starts up conflict in the community. It starts up conflict. A conflict instrument. Starts up conflict. You won't have any problem until you have them. Once you have them, give me 5 minutes. 5 minutes? Okay, three. You're about to start having problems. Thank you, Jesus.
Hey, Lord.
Living to please God.
Yes, Lord.
I want you to know today that God loves you.
Yes, Lord.
I want you to know that nothing shall be impossible for you.
Thank
put your hope in God. Walk with God for you.
Yeah.
Be willing to seek His face and pray. Wait on the Lord and be of good courage. And with have fainted, others have been to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait on the Lord and be of good courage. And shall strengthen your heart. You belong to Him.
Yeah.
Hallelujah!
Yeah. Yeah.
My love is in the hand of God.
Yeah.
My love is in the hand of God. What do you think doesn't matter? You know I love you, but I'm divinely protected.
Yeah.
Come right now, go with it. I don't have to go. You know. Come right now, go with it.
Yeah.
Hope everybody can say the same.
Yeah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. God love you. God care about you. You are somebody to Him. Watch your steps. What people you hang around. If you have to hide the Christianity around some people, then they are the wrong group. Hallelujah. You should not be ashamed of the gospel or ashamed of who God is in your life. Hallelujah. Thank you. Don't let anybody trick you because every time they come around, they are about to take your money. They spend $10 and you take $400. It never fails. It's a wise, shrewd, worldly people. But he said, indeed, it says, who? Get to work. Why not? You know, I love the work. Get to work. Lick. You know, there's one thing to have a tick and a dog. A dog, they get on the leech and get sucked in. But sometimes you have a two leech and no dog.
Yeah.
Oh, baby, God told me to my wife for how long? He told somebody else that 2 weeks ago, but to get in their pants. God will go through my wife, okay? We see. Because until you get a ring, no wed, no bed, no eight, no day.
Amen.
No test driving a discount.
Amen.
I said, when I got the trailer, I'm not a demon, I'm original.
Amen.
What are you, a demon? The Bible says, therefore, for the man being Christ is a new creature, not a demon.
Yes.
A new creation.
Yes.
Not a demon creation.
Yes.
On test drive, go down the street.
Yes.
No treasure, no trading. Hallelujah. Well, praise God. I give you control. Hey, bring the revenue for the end. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you.